spent across 2,000 kilometers with 600 billion tons of ice, the Himalayas are the highest mountain on Earth. They are also one of our planet's greatest water reserves in the form of glacial ice and snow. They give shelter to billions of people and feed 10 biggest rivers of Asia. Snow and glaciers in these mountains contains the largest volume of the fresh water outside the Earth's polar ice sheet. Researchers across the world have reiterated that at the present rate of melting, the world's glacier could be gone by 2050. Over the last few decades, warmer temperature caused by the rising carbon and methane emission and intensifying greenhouse gases have led to unusually high rates of ice melting and evaporation. In the last two decades, we have also lost over 270 billion tons of ice. The meltwater produced now accounts for about fifth of the global sea level rise. During this time, polar ice sheet, mountain glaciers, and the sea ice have all seen a dramatic reduction. Hello, my name is Aakash, a climate change activist. I grew up in Indore, Madhya Pradesh in India, about 50 miles from the Tropic of Cancer, which makes this region prone to a more serious summer, a winter many times harsh. But today, I call these mighty mountains my home. The Indian Himalayas and I share a unique bond since I was 12 years old. So today, when it's grappling in its worst natural calamity, as a lifelong student of climate science, I am here at the forefront to champion sustainability through my advocacy in climate change for India and for the globe. The melting of glaciers and climate change go hand in hand. Since the advent of the Industrial Revolution, carbon dioxide, methane, and other greenhouse gases emission have raised temperatures even higher in the poles, and as a result, glaciers are rapidly melting. Climate change is real, and human actions are the defining cause behind it. No corner of the world is resistant to this damaging impact of climate change. But we are far from being powerless and victimized. We can and must take action. Declaring climate emergency is the starting point for it. The United Nations, in its report published in March 2019, says we could have just 11 years left to limit a climate change catastrophe. Just 11 years. In the last 20 years, we have lost almost 270 billion tons of ice. The meltwater produced now accounts for about 21% of the total global sea level rise. Between 1994 to 2017, the planet has lost 28 trillion tons of ice. At present rate of melting, the world glaciers could be gone by 2050. The smoke that's released from the forest fire deposits a black powder on glaciers. Sunlight is absorbed by the dark-colored ash sitting on the glaciers, and the heat melts the ice. The darkness absorbs more heat than the white material. Pristine white snow reflects more than 90% of the incoming solar radiation back to the atmosphere. But when snow is blanketed by the darker colored particle dust, the coating absorbs more heat and the snow melts faster. This affects the communities surrounding the Himalayas, which are some of the poorest communities in the world, and they bear the maximum burnt of climate change. As an avid nature lover, each day comes as a revelation when I started learning more about climate science. My greatest passion, travel, took me to places I've never heard about, and there I stood witness to the disparity between the rich and poor. The stories of climate migrants shook me. I witnessed how the melting of ice directly impacted the biodiversity of the region, the economy, and employment opportunities of the localities. News of landslides, floods, and avalanches instilled a sense of fear. This is when I found my true calling as a climate activist. So here I am at 27, spreading climate awareness over the last 8 years. In October 2019, more than 13,000 scientists from 156 countries signed a report to signify their agreement that the world is facing a climate emergency that requires bold action. While you're listening to this talk, our planet is under serious threat of climate change. And somewhere, in some part of the world, our fellow humans are facing extreme weather events such as heat waves, droughts, storms, and floods. the rising sea level and the melting ice caps are influencing the flora and fauna of the region first and then creating an unfortunate impact on human life. Countries are sinking and sometimes stinking with the fear of food security, water security, health crisis while the planet reaches its tipping point. It is the need of the hour that the forces across the world unites to announce climate emergency. In declaring climate emergency, a government admits that climate change exists and that the measures taken up to this point are not enough to limit the changes brought by it. The specific term emergency is used to assign priority to the topic and to generate a mindset of urgency. But is this enough? On one hand, developed countries such as United Kingdom, Ireland, Canada, and France have declared climate emergencies. On the other hand, they also sponsor billions of dollars to support the fossil fuel industry at home or abroad. This is just one example of how just words are not enough. According to an IPCC report, India, which flaunts a coastline of over 7,500 kilometers, faces a serious threat to those living in the areas vulnerable to the impact of sea level rise. Six Indian port cities, Chennai, Kochi, Kolkata, Mumbai, Surat, and Vishakhapatnam, houses over 28.6 million people who are living in the fear of coastal flooding. If the sea level rise by 50 centimeters, only by 50 centimeters, this also means that asset worth $4 trillion will be damaged. The International Center for Integrated Mountain Development claims that one-third of these glaciers, the Himalayas and the Hindu Kush Mountains, will melt by the end of the century even if the current efforts to reduce climate change succeed. If we fail, they will melt by two-thirds. At the risk is the livelihood and security of nearly 2 billion people. Even if we stay under the 1.5 degree limit, 9.6% of animal species and 8% of the plant species will go extinct. By 2050, over 25 million would be displaced worldwide, having to leave their home. We all need to play our part. As a climate change activist, I travel responsibly. Often, I choose cycling, walking, hitchhiking, and public transport to reduce my carbon footprint. I have been a vegan for the last 6 years. I have also conceived and created 3 art installations in Kerala, Uttarakhand, and Himachal Pradesh in India to raise awareness on the harmful usage of single-use plastic. During the COVID-19 pandemic, I published my first book on climate change. All these experiences have only taken me one step forward in doing my bit for the planet. So I invite you, you and you to join me and of many my friends across the globe who are addressing the climate change in their own unique ways. It's now or never. Today, I stand in Leh, India, a westernmost Himalayan mountain range in the minus 15 degrees Celsius, delivering this talk. This is my home and it's melting. I request leaders across the globe to join me in this quest and declare climate emergency.